So, Hannah England goes in this one for Great Britain. Runs for Oxford City, fourth in the Commonwealth Games last year. She won the British Trials, beating Lita Zabriskie. With about 550 metres to go, it's going to be a real tear-up. So Hilali is on the shoulder of Gezahine. Robery's there. Yevdokimova, the tall Russian, tucked in on the inside. Langat now starting to make her presence felt. The Olympic champion, the Commonwealth champion. And now Hannah England of Great Britain moving up wide on the outside. Still a massive group of 10 together as they hit the bell in the first heat of this women's 1500 metres. Only six to go through. There's a little bit of bumping and barging going on there as Hannah England going wide on the outside. Nancy Langat, the Olympic champion, back in about fifth place, and they're all queuing up, and there's not going to be room for all of them because this has been incredibly slow. Shevchenko of the Ukraine running in what, lane three or four on the outside, coming high and wide. Hannah England now onto the shoulder of Nancy Langat. Still we've got Gezahine on the inside and Hilali now, the Moroccan. She goes with 200 metres to go, trying just to make sure of qualification. Hannah England's in a good spot here. I tell you what, Gezahine's going backwards here. She's going to need to put her foot down, the fancied Ethiopian. So we've got Hilali, we've got Nancy Langat, Hannah England. Going really well here. Belete, the Bahrainian, coming up onto her shoulder. Hannah England is going to qualify and do so in style. There's a faller there. I wonder if it's Yevdokimova. Hannah England's going to take it. Belete comes through. And who was it who fell? Well, we'll bring you the update on that when we can. But that was a really, really good performance from Hannah England because it was so, so slow. There was surely no chance that they were going to be able to come through as a fastest loser. Good performance by the British woman.
Very mature run there by Hannah. I was actually a bit worried because she seemed to be going the long way round. At one stage, she was nearly in lane three. Obviously, the inside lane, you're going to be running the shortest distance, but she had to go wide to stay out of trouble. She timed it to perfection. She looked very strong in the home straight. Very mature run. She's even looking up at the scoreboard. She's confident.
That was a really, really good run there by Hannah England. It was a fairly loaded field. Hilali set the pace most of the way around. Belete did well, the former Ethiopian. It was Nikki Hamlin of New Zealand who fell, the two times silver medalist at the Commonwealth Games last year. But Hannah England doing really well there. And she'll take huge confidence from that. And I wonder what her reflections are. She's down trackside with Sonia.
She's just shouting at one of her competitors. That's the way to do qualifying, isn't it?
It's good. I wanted to run it every race as a final, like, you know, and hopefully be able to shut it down in the last 50. And it's hard to tell in the perspective they had on the screen because I looked around the bottom bend and I was like, oh, there's still loads of people. I've got to just sprint. And I've got a day off tomorrow, so I was like, oh, it doesn't matter. Like, I've got plenty of time to recover.
It was quite a pedestrian pace. At any point during that race, did you think, oh, I do need to inject some pace here?
Not really. I tend to be able to finish quite well off a pace like that. I mean, I felt really, really comfortable. I was looking at the clock thinking, oh, I should feel comfortable, but it was nice just to feel relaxed and not stressed about it.
This is your first global championships. You look to the manner born, but I wonder, were there any butterflies?
Yeah, a lot. it's just a great atmosphere, and I love being in the village, and being a world championship is just a lot of fun.
It is. Well, you've done yourself proud already. Well done.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
So confirmation then, Hannah England, a really, really mature qualification. And look at that, in seventh place, Kalkadine Gezahine, the second fastest woman in the world this year. I thought the Ethiopian looked like she was struggling in the final 150 metres, and it'll be doubtful whether 4:14 is good enough to go through as a fastest loser. Personal best for the Zimbabwean, and unlucky for Nikki Hamlin, who fell.